everyone, my name is Kuro from Omomo Markham, and today I'll be showing you guys how to make a black sesame and matcha shot latte using products and kitchenware that can all be found at Omomo stores. So the items that I'll be using today are black sesame latte mix, matcha powder, a milk frother, a tall glass, a straw, preferably reusable, a large and a small measuring cup, a cute coaster, and of course some ice. The first thing that I'll be making is the shot of matcha. So at Omomo, you can find matcha powder in both a bag or a canister type of container like this one. And I chose this one since you can keep the matcha inside of the tin and the lid is actually pretty airtight, so you don't have to worry about it spilling. There isn't really an exact measurement per se for matcha. It doesn't say anything on the container. You can just kind of adjust it to the taste that you like since matcha will add quite a bit of bitterness to your drink. So for this, I used about 2 teaspoons of matcha and about 60 milliliters of almost boiling water. Since I don't have an actual matcha whisk at home, I decided to use a milk frother instead. And I'd say it got the job done pretty well. So after it's all mixed together, I set it aside so I can make the latte. So what's really nice about this black sesame latte mix is that it already comes in a resealable bag, so you don't need to try and find a place to store the leftovers. You can just zip it up and leave it in its original packaging. The instructions on the back also show that you can make this either hot or cold. Today I'll be making it an iced version, and you can also use dairy or non-dairy milk. So what the instructions say is to mix 150 milliliters of dairy or non-dairy milk, either hot or cold, with 2 tablespoons, which is 2 sets of 15 grams, of the latte mix powder. It's also nice to note that it does specifically say yamamori in Japanese, which means heaping, so you don't want to level the spoon when you're scooping up the powder, otherwise it might taste a little more diluted than what they intended it to be. Again, I'll be using my electric milk frother to mix together the milk and the latte mix powder. If you're using a frother or some type of whisk to mix this as well, you'll also want to make sure that whatever you're mixing it in is a little taller since it does foam up quite a bit. For this video, I also decided to use some cute jewel-shaped ice molds since kind of unique ice is something that I really love in home cafe videos. So this product in itself is really unique in that it comes with 2 sets of trays which also both have lids. So you can stack them on top of each other to save space inside of your freezer and you don't have to worry about them kind of falling over and spilling everywhere. Now that both the latte and matcha is complete, it's time to put everything together. So it's confession time again. The visual of this drink was not what I was hoping for. I thought it would stay in like nicer layers or a nicer gradient or something. I wasn't compensating all of the gray colored foam that would rise to the top and it just kind of ended up looking like weird swamp water. I will say that the amount of matcha that I added did make the drink a little bit too bitter, and I also used unsweetened almond milk, which already kind of tastes like nothing, so I ended up adding about 2 pumps worth of simple syrup, which is just a 1-to-1 ratio of water and sugar that's boiled and heated up, and the taste was honestly perfect for me. So, although the drink is not as aesthetically pleasing as the dalgona coffee, it's still equally delicious and super, super easy to make. Thank you guys again so much for watching. Feel free to follow us on our social media to stay updated, and I hope you all have an amazing day.